Hi, I'm Pat Reeder.
And I'm George Gamark.
We are the authors of this brilliant and impossible-to-find book, Hollywood Hi-Fi, A History of Bizarre Celebrity Recordings, and we're reviewing a few of those for you here on video.
Yeah. Oh, you know, when it comes to singing, celebrity singing, I Love Lucy, we had Desi Arnaz, obviously a talented band leader who came to the U.S.
and
made quite a career. Lucy tried to sing occasionally.
She was in the movie Mame.
Okay.
Bad idea.
Bad idea. Wildcat.
Wildcat, the Broadway show. Another bad idea.
Did Vivian Vance ever sing?
Vivian Vance did sing some. Of course, you always saw her on the TV show singing, but who was she singing with on the TV show?
Fred Mertz.
That's right. William Frawley. William Frawley was the real singer in the cast of I Love Lucy. Every time you would see him, he'd always want to do the old vaudeville shows, right?
That's because he was an old vaudeville.
He actually was. He was. Part of the reason he was hired for the gig was that he had vaudeville skills. He used to perform in the small-time theaters doing the old turn-of-the-century songs.
Didn't he claim to be the first guy ever to sing Melancholy Baby?
He did. Melancholy Baby was allegedly written in the back room of a saloon. They needed a singer. Bill Frawley, of course, was right there.
Carolina in the Morning.
He sang. That's another biggie you'd hear him do.
He was 71 at the time he cut this record.
Yeah, this record came out when I Love Lucy was being filmed originally.
1958.
You would see him do it on TV, and somebody thought, hey, you know, this seems to go over well with the audience at home. Let's cash in. Let's get Bill Frawley to drag his old vaudeville act out of mothballs and put on the old straw hat and haul out the ukulele and do a few of these old songs for old folks. This was, by the way, done in lieu of doing a spin-off sitcom featuring Fred and Ethel. There was some talk of that, but
oh my,
a little problem with that. You see that
I guess this album didn't have any problem getting in the way of those Pat Boone records that Dot was doing.
And it didn't interrupt the sitcom plans either, because as you know, Vivian Vance referred to William Frawley as, what was it again?
That square-headed drunken Irish slob.
Yes, is it? That square-headed drunken Irish slob. He referred to her as that no-talent fat-ass bag of bones. And
she was 22 years younger than
he was. Well, she replied, I wouldn't do a spinoff with him for any amount of money. That was the direct quote, I believe. So instead of having that, we got this album. Bill Frawley sings the old ones. And boy, oh boy, does he. We've always said that there's probably a copy of this in Leon Redbone's closet somewhere.
The only person who would know these songs is Georgie Jessel, and he's dead.
Oh, yeah, you've got some greats of Swanee River, Moonlight Bay, Shine on Harvest Moon, all the things you would expect. So let's play a little cut here. Dig out your I Love Lucy t-shirts and turn it up, folks. We're going to listen to Bill Frawley as he sings the old ones.
I'll get the Vitaphone.
Nothing could be finer than to be in Carolina in the morning. And no one could be sweeter than my sweetie when I meet her in the morning. Where all the morning glories twine around my door while they're whispering pretty little stories that I love to hear once more.